It's Anthony with Land Title. This is our first to know update for the month of May. And here what you can see is we've seen a little bit of slippage in the price. Now, that was the peak of the market last year in May. Here we are, you know, it's a little bit of a slowdown this year, but honestly, this is about the peak of our seasonal time as well. So you can see that we're down about 2.4% average sales price, median's about the same. Now, if we go over to the condo townhouse markets, you can see that we're down a little bit less than that. Now, consumer behavior has obviously changed quite a bit because when you're shopping on payment, which is what most consumers are doing, you used to be able to buy a lot more for your money than you can today. So think 14, 16 months ago, right? 3-4% interest rates, and here we are today at pushing 7. Obviously, you've had to change their consumer behavior, and it looks like they're moving a little bit more towards the attached product type. Now, this one is what really gets me because we're showing our price per square foot has come down almost 6% from this time last year. So that's a cause to be a little bit concerned because that means prices are slipping a little bit. And that's not the worst thing in the world, right? Because they were way overinflated last year. I don't think you're going to be there in quarters 3 or 4 because quarter 4 last year was so tough, right? We chased prices down for what looked like about 9 or 10 months before we hit January. So expect that this is all going to solve itself with a little bit of time. And we didn't have too much of an overinflated market back this time last year. Now, the one that really gets me here is we are only up 1.7% from this time last year in active units, right? And then we started seeing just tons of inventory coming on the market. Now, a lot of that was that inventory wasn't coming off the market, right? So we've had a lot of buyer behavior absorbing a lot of the inventory coming to the market because we just have a lot of pent-up demand. Now, the problem is we have a lot more pent-up demand if interest rates would slip some. So be concerned that, you know, if interest rates come down too fast, you could see a landslide of buyers come into the marketplace. If we do not see that, you could see a big seasonal change. Look at 2019, that's the green line there. Or last year, the light blue line, we could start to see some major inventory rise into the month of July because July tends to have a little bit of a slowdown. New listings tend to continue to come to market and we just won't have the buyers to absorb them. But as of right now, inventory has stayed remarkably stable. So that's a good sign as far as where the market's at today. Now, one of the biggest reasons that that's happening is our pending listings, even though they've slipped 25%, which is a remarkable amount, we just have seen a big pullback in the amount of sellers coming to market, right? So that's really important to see that the listings have slowed down, the buyers have slowed down. It looks like those sellers are either waiting for interest rates to come down because they can't trade, or they just don't see that it's a real favorable time to sell, which I would actually argue with pretty heavily, because even though last year was this crazy seller's market, right? We had like a week of inventory in the beginning of the year. Here we are at 1.3 months of inventory. It's a super strong seller's market in Denver Metro right now, right? If you want to sell a home, you're definitely getting top dollar for it. Top dollar this year might not be the same as top dollar last year, but top dollar is top dollar, and this might be your last month to get that before we go into a summer or even fall market where, you know, prices don't tend to be quite as easy as they are right now. And I'll show you why. The fastest part of the market is always May, June, maybe into July. And you see that saddle where, you know, we're at 21 days right now. 21 days is remarkably fast for active to under contract time. Just because the last couple of years we've been sub 10, maybe one of the fastest markets in the entire United States. Here we are, 100.5% list of sale price. People are still getting bidding wars. So it's a seller favorable market, right? If you're a buyer, it's still tough out there, right? You guys are all feeling that if you're working with first-time home buyers or even buyers in those lower price points. So one thing I just wanted to point out here is if you're a seller, get sellers to market soon if you're working with sellers. If you're working with buyers, tell them to hang in there because it looks like the latter half of the year, there will be a little reprieve as long as interest rates don't fall off of a cliff, which they don't appear to be doing so. It appears like we're in for the long haul on some of this stuff. So if you have any questions, you need any submarkets, obviously that data is much more granular, right? We're feeling different things in different markets taking place. So reach out to me about the submarket data. I'm Anthony at Land Title, and I hope to catch you on the next video. Thank you. One of these next slides. One of the